Father's Day to all the fathers, all the dads. Praise God. Thank God for those that are standing fast and holding up the bloodstained banner, being men in the home. Praise God. Truly leading out. Praise the Lord. It tells you to be the head. That means that you lead out. It doesn't mean that you're the boss and the taskmaster. I mean that you're leading your family. You're leading them in the right direction. Praise God. You're leading them in worship and praise, and you're leading them in the word of truth. You're being that pastor in that home. You're being that priest. Praise the Lord. So we thank God this morning for just being good to us and just continually blessing us with his gifts of love. I'm going to read scripture this morning coming from Psalms 8. And it says, O Lord, our Lord, how excellent is thy name in all the earth, who has set thy glory above the heavens. Out of the mouths of babes and suckling hast thou ordained strength because of thy enemies, and that thou mightest steal the enemy and the avenger. When I consider thy heaven, the works of thy fingers, the moon, the stars, which thou hast ordained, what is man that thou art mindful of him, and the son of man that thou visit him? For thou hast made him a little lower than the angels, and hast crowned him with glory and honor. Thou madest him to have dominion over the works of thy hand. Thou hast put all things under his feet, all sheep and oxen, yea, and the beast of the field, the fowl of the air, and the fish of the sea, and whatsoever passes through the paths of the sea. O Lord, our Lord, how excellent is thy name in all the earth. Praise God. Merciful Father, we thank you today, for your name is excellent. We praise you, Lord God. So we worship you. We give you the glory. We give you the honor for being all that you are, Lord God. We thank you as you continue to show yourself to us, as you show us your many different sides, Lord God. Show us your wonders and your giftings, Lord God, and your healings, Lord God. Oh, Father God, and knowing and understanding that you are the God of the breakthrough, and knowing that there is nothing too hard for you, for everything is in your hands, Lord God. Oh, I love it when the scripture says you sit on the circle of the earth, Lord God. There's nothing that is hidden from you, Lord God. You see the confusion, you see the chaos that's happening in our world and our earth today, Lord God. You see the plague that has moved upon the earth. All things are before you, Lord God. We pray unto you because you are the author and the finish of all things, Lord God. We pray that your precious will be done, Lord God, that men will be drawn closer to you, that men will begin to see your glory and understand your goodness and understand that you're the only hope for mankind. Oh, Lord, we just pray right now that you strengthen us as your witnesses, Lord God, that you bless your people that are standing throughout the earth, Lord God, those that are going through persecution and tribulation, Lord God, just for your name's sake, Lord God, our brothers and sisters, Lord God, that are being put in prison, praise God, in other countries, Lord God, just for saying your name, accused of blasphemy, and, oh, Father God, all types of things, Lord God, just because they declare your glory, Father God. We just pray for them right now, Lord. We just ask that you touch in a mighty way. We pray right now that our prayer will encourage, our prayer will touch. We say the prayer of the righteous availeth much, Lord God. Father, we just ask right now that you have your way, Lord God, that you continue to move in the earth, Lord God. As we come before your presence this morning, open up our hearts to your word, Lord God. Oh, open up our hearts to your word. This is not about us, but it's about you being glorified, Father. Let us go forth in your glory. Let all pride, let all flesh be crucified before you right now in the name of Jesus, Lord God, that we can move in the spirit realm, Lord God, and we'll have a mindset to work and to move in the kingdom, Lord God. Oh, Father, we pray that your will be done on earth as it is in heaven right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Save and touch, Lord God. Oh, Father, we thank you right now. We thank you for all things. Your name is excellent, excellent in all the earth, Lord. And we give you the praise, Lord God. We give you the glory. We praise you, Lord, with our whole heart. With our whole heart, we show forth all. We want to show forth all thy marvelous works. We want to show forth all your marvelous works, Lord. We praise you right now. Amen, amen. We just thank God today for just blessing and keeping us. Praise God. We do. We want to praise him, and we want to show forth his marvelous works. And the Bible says to us in Psalms 9:1 that we should do this with our whole heart. Praise God. I will show forth all that marvelous work, but I'm going to do it. I'm doing it with my whole heart. He said, I will be glad and rejoice in thee. I will sing praises to thy name, O thou most high. He said, I'm going to give you the glory. He said, I'm going to praise you. How am I going to praise you? We've been talking about the heart for these last few weeks. As we move, as we say, we're moving in the divine power of God. But I said before, it is truly impossible for us to do it if our heart is not lined up with God's will. Our hearts must be lined up with God's will. That's where God wants to work. God wants to work in our heart, in our spirit. Praise God. That's what the Bible says. We've got to love with all our heart. With all our heart. We've got to love with all our heart, all our mind, all that's within us. Praise God. We've got to love God. And God wants to work in the heart. We have to serve him. Praise the Lord. In the will and desire of the heart. And God wants to implant himself in us. And that's why we have to have a hunger and thirst for his word, praise God, because it is in the heart that the voice and the Son of God must be received. It is in the heart that the voice and the Son of God must be received. It's in the heart, praise the Lord. So we have to continue to pray and say, Lord, I need your word. Psalms 143:8 says to us this morning, he says, cause me to hear thy loving kindness in the morning, for in thee do I trust. Cause me to know the way wherein I should walk, for I lift up my soul unto thee. He said, I need to know your way. I want to hear your loving kindness. We're in a lot of stuff right now, a lot of negative things, a lot of things that are disturbing. Praise God, that's constantly going forth right now on the earth. That are really shaking this country right now. But I'm praying, even though these things, I'm hearing these things, I still pray hard just to hear the Lord, praise God. I want to hear your loving kindness. I want to hear the Lord. You know why I want to hear the Lord? Because I want to be able to give a word of hope to somebody. I want to be able to still encourage somebody, praise God, and let them know that God is still on the throne, that God is still in power, praise God, no matter what law they bring down or what may come, praise God. You got to know that your God is sitting on high. And he says, deliver me, O Lord, from my enemies. I flee unto thee to hide me. We see everything he's saying. He said, Lord, I'm running unto you. He said, teach me to do thy will, for thou art my God. Thy spirit is good. He said, lead me into the land of uprightness. He said, teach me to do what? To do your will. Teach me, Lord, to do your will. That's why with our whole heart, we got to worship him. We got to serve him. Teach me to do your will. Praise God. I want to have this relationship. We have to understand some of our relationship. I said before, it's cultivated. It's not automatic. The relationship we're supposed to have with God, it don't come just automatically. It has to be cultivated. God say, come unto me, and we can come unto him, but it has to be a mindset of wanting him to work in us. Come unto me, all you that labor and heavy laden. He said, take my yoke upon you. You see, we got to come, we got to learn of him. We got to understand who he is. I said before, a week or so ago, about we fail a lot of times in the process of salvation, the process of sanctification. Praise the Lord, but God is still working in us. God is still moving in us. God wants to have his will and his way moving in our life. Praise God. And we got to understand that our purpose will never be manifested. Praise God. And the will of God will not be manifested until God sets us apart and begins to work in our spirit and work in our heart. And remember, we were talking about David in Psalms 51. And we have talked about the things that David requested. Remember, we said he requested a clean heart, and he wanted a right spirit, a steadfast spirit. He told God to restore the joy. And we were talking about on last week, praise God, his divine purpose. He had a desire for his divine purpose, and he had a desire for his divine purpose. Why? In Psalms 51:13, he said, "Teach." He said, "Then will I teach transgressors thy way, and sinners shall be converted unto thee. He said, I want to tell people what your purpose is. He said, Jesus told the disciples, say, go ye. And that's what the mindset we have to have as people of God. And we have to go ye. We have to tell the world about this God. We have to lift him up. Praise the Lord. But this is going to come through us learning and having the knowledge of God, having a relationship with God, letting God move in us, letting God get us spiritually fit, praise the Lord, to stand the test, to stand the trials, to stand the situations and circumstances that's going to come up on you. We got to be spiritually fit. That's why he told them not to come out of the upper room until they be endowed, until they're clothed with the power of God. We need the power of God because the power of God gives us the authority to be able to stand in these times that we live in. It gives us the power to speak his word. Peter spoke his word when all the people around him said they must be drunk, but he lifted up God. He praised him. Praise the Lord. And we have to be able to, in the midst of this generation that we live in, praise God, and the ungodliness that's around us, we have to be willing to lift up the power and the authority of God. We can't faint. I always talk about that scripture in 2 Corinthians, the 4th chapter, praise the Lord, where he tells us we can't faint. We can't faint at the word. We can't faint at the truth. We can't faint at the righteousness that God has given us. We have to have that mind that Samuel had. The Bible said he didn't let the word hit the ground. Are we holding up the word? Are we holding up the truth? He didn't say hold up a church. He said hold up the word. Hold up the word. He said just for a minute to read it, 2 Corinthians 4 and 1. And I'm not trying to be redundant, but a lot of times we only learn through redundancy. Things have to be said and repeated over and over. Praise God, to get it into our mind, to get it into our spirit. But he said, therefore seeing, praise God, seeing we have this ministry, as we have received mercy, we what faint not. We cannot faint. Listen to me, church. It's no time to faint. People of God, it's no time to faint. It's time to go forth in purpose. It's time to walk forth and go forth in the purpose of God. It's time to plant and proclaim the kingdom of God. Purpose is an aim, praise God. Purpose is an intentional resolution. We got to be intentional about the things of God. I'm living this life on purpose. I'm living this life on purpose. Praise God. We got to intentionally, praise the Lord, stand for God. God wants to use us. We saw that in Philippians 3, 13 and 14. He wants to work in us. He wants to move in us. He wants his potential to be shown in our lives, praise God, that we're going forth in the power of God. We said potential is existing in a possibility, capable of becoming actual. Praise God, the things of God actually coming forth and manifesting itself in our life. God wants to develop us, continue to work in us. He said, therefore, seeing we have this, don't you faint. Don't you give up. He said, but have renounced the hidden things of dishonesty, not walking in craftiness, nor handling the word of God deceitfully, but by the manifestation of truth, commending ourselves to every man's conscience. Doing what? Commending ourselves to every man's conscience. Every man's conscience, he says here, in the sight of God. But if our gospel, good news, if our gospel be what? Be hid, praise God. If our gospel is hidden, what is it? Is hidden? Hidden from them that are what? That are lost. If we veil it, if we hide it. He's talking about if we veil our gospel, we hide our gospel. So many people need to hear the word. And I'm telling you something, sometimes the truth and the truth of the gospel is veiled because of religious mindsets, because of traditions, praise the Lord, because I feel this way and I think that way. That's why I said David had the prayer of cleansing. That 51st Psalm was a prayer of cleansing. We need to let God, totally cleanse us of our mindset, our old habits. Praise God. Things we thought were supposed to go one way and thought they were supposed to go another. One thing I loved about my pastor, that if he found out, if God spoke to his heart and began to show him another way, that he would change and he would even come back to the church and apologize. Not a lot of pastors going to apologize because they don't ever want to seem wrong. And they look weak before folks. But he wanted to be honest before God. And he said, you know what? This is really what God wants from us. This is really what God desires of us, because he was following a brotherhood. Praise God. And it's brotherhood. There's nothing wrong with brotherhoods as long as they stay within the realm of what God has called them to do. But sometimes we can get caught up in man's mindset and man's wisdom and what men think are right and what the board want to do. We got to do what God calls us to do. And that's why he said, you don't faint. It get veiled, our spirit, our ministries and works get veiled sometime by our thinking. It gets veiled by our action. It gets veiled, praise God, because we begin to take on these ideologies and mindsets and traditional things, and we veil it, praise God, because there's people that's lost that need to understand this, that need to hear this. I was so glad when I came into the church that my pastor didn't beat me down. Didn't beat me down. I'm sitting here. I was a sinner. Praise the Lord. I had earrings in my ear. I was looking crazy. They thought I was going to rob the church. They really did. The pastor's wife told me, she said, son, I thought you were going to rob us. I told the people, and I said, watch him. But I needed Jesus. I was looking toe up, praise God, because I was in a hopeless situation. I was homeless, praise the Lord. I needed something, and the world was not giving it to me, because all the world was doing was wearing me out. The devil was trying to kill me. He was taking everything he could from me, praise God. He wanted to destroy me, wanted to destroy me. But this beautiful man of God, he didn't one time speak about what I had on or how I looked, praise God. He just kept giving me the word of God. And then even after church, he would meet me at the back door and still be trying to encourage me. And that touched my heart. That touched my heart, praise God, because he was diligent. Diligent. He wasn't trying to get any money because I was broke. He was diligent about giving me the word and letting me understand who God was. And I thank him. Praise God. That was in 1974. I praise him. I thank God for what he did. Praise the Lord. In my life as a young man at 20 some years old. And that's why we can't faint. Don't let it get veiled by your mindset. Don't let it get veiled by your thinking. As a pastor, I try to stay as open as I can to what God wants to say and what God wants to do. I'm not going to sit here and put a noose around the young people and shut them down. You got to listen to what they say, because the church has to go forth. The church has to grow, praise God. And so he says to us here, if we just make it like we want it to be, then those that are lost won't get the word. He says it to us in 2 Corinthians 4:4. He said, in whom the God of this world, and we understand small g, the devil, the God of this world. I want you to understand something, if you don't know it, that the reason, the condition that the world is in is because the enemy is the God of this world. He's the God of this world. And he's leading men into the confusion. Look at the confusion and the destruction, praise God, and the hatred. And all these things that are going forth in our world today, praise God. They were there all the time, hidden and laying dormant. But all these things that are manifesting themselves now, even in a whole nother generation of hatred, praise God, of people angry with each other because of the color of your skin, all the things that's happening. But Jesus said this. Jesus said there's going to be nations against nations. And that when he's speaking about races against races, praise God. And we see here that he's saying the God of this world, what he's going to do, he's blinding the mind. He wants to blind the mind. Listen, he wants to blind the mind. This is why we got to keep praying. Lord, empower me. Give me the influence, praise God, of your spirit, the influence of your word, praise God. I want to be one that's an influencer, praise God. But I can't do it if it's veiled. He said, but in whom the God of this world has blinded the minds of them which believe not, lest the light of the glorious gospel of Christ, who is the image of God, should shine unto them. I love what Paul says in the 5th verse, 2 Corinthians 4:5. For we preach not ourselves. Preachers, it ain't about you. We preach not ourselves. It ain't about you having a good message and people hearing you and all the antics that we do. Praise God. I mean, one time I was at a church and the preacher taught, he taught in the beginning, God, the message was beautiful. And I went to the basement to shake his hand and tell him I enjoyed the message. You know what he said to me? He said, wow, you should hear me at my church. You know, he's a visitor. You should hear me at my church. And one of the brothers said, yeah, you need to come to our church and hear him. I'm like, what in the world? I said, you know, I'm looking at him like, this is not about you. It's not about how good you preach. We're doing a lot of preaching, but no reaching. God needs folks that are reaching. God needs people that's going to go forth and be a sacrifice, going to be a sacrifice for him, a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable. He said, this is your reasonable service, not somebody getting up trying to show out, trying to get the sisters to holler, trying to get a bigger offering. This ain't what it's about. Praise God. Some of us wouldn't make it in some of the third world countries. Not at all. We leave, we flee, we run off. Because we couldn't take the pressure. We couldn't take the persecution. Some of the things we're going through in America, man, it's not a persecution like some of these other people are going through. We're not being put in concentration camps and put in prison, praise God, and our churches are getting burned down and our women are getting raped on the way to church. This is not happening. This is not happening, but these people continue to preach, continue to lift up God. I have a friend that's in South Africa running a ministry right now, and he writes to me and tells me about the things that's happening, praise God, and all the things they're going to bring forth and to manifest the glory of God. Listen, he said the devil want to keep the minds blind. He wants to keep them from seeing the glorious gospel. This is what it's all about. Paul said, for we preach not ourselves. Don't preach yourself, because we got too many faults. We got too many flaws. And baby, they will show up. But preach him, manifest him. David, great as he was, the giant killer, praise God. You know, they sung a song about David. They sung a song about David, made Saul mad. They said David, Saul killed his thousands, but David killed his 10,000s. This giant killer, Philistine whooper, praise God. This worshiper fell. But he realized it wasn't about him. It was about God's glory. For we preach not ourselves, but Christ Jesus the Lord, and ourselves your servant. Paul said, you know what I am? He said, I'm a servant. I'm a servant. If you're a pastor, you're a leader today, you're a servant. You're supposed to serve the people, not get served. It's okay for them to do some things for you, but don't expect that. I heard men say they took a offer from you to give me enough money. They should have took it all back. But the thing is, we should be servants, for we preach not ourselves. For God, who commanded the light to shine out of darkness, has shined in our hearts. Where did he shine? Where does God want to shine the light? Come on, y'all. Where does he want to shine the light? In our heart. Hallelujah. He wants the light to shine in your heart, to give the light of knowledge of the glory of God in the face of Jesus Christ. So we can give what? Knowledge. So we can go forth. Listen, this is what this is about. That's why I said relationship is not cultivated, not automatic. And when you get the true relationship of God in your life, it changes perspective. True relationship changes perspective. You begin to see things different. You begin, changes come in your life. Every time Moses went before the glory of God, he came down white. Something is supposed to change in your life. I don't walk around with the same attitude, the same ugliness in me, and I say I'm saved. I don't walk around, praise God, bitter and mad about my past and say I'm saved. I have to move on. I have to go, because God wants to shine his light through me. That's why sowing is so important. Because whatever you entertain, you're going to retain. Whatever you entertain, you'll retain. If you're entertaining all this bitterness and hurt, praise God, if you retain that, and that's what the enemy got you entertaining in your mind and all those things, because that's what he wants to work in your mind. That's why God wants to renew your mind. And you got to stand the battle. You got to stand the fight, because all this stuff is sitting there. Paul says, sin is always present with me. You got to say, Lord, give me a clean heart. Give me a right spirit. David prayed for that, because I've got a divine purpose that I've got to be about. That's why my spiritual fitness is important. And whatever you sow, that's what you're going to reap. If you're sowing, the Bible says to us in Galatians 6, 7, and 8, if I'm sowing to the spirit, I'm going to reap spirit. But if I'm sowing to my flesh, my carnal nature, that's what's going to come forth. That's what's going to come forth. That's why we got to have a mind. Lord, help me. Help me to be that new creature. Lord, help me to be that ambassador. Help me to be that kingdom representative. Help me to be those things, praise God. that we can go forth, that we can manifest his glory. That help us as churches to get out of church fights and all these different things that the enemy is causing because somebody wants to be great. You be great in God, in the power of his might. Move in the glory of God. Hallelujah. Because God is the one that's going to give you a reward. Anniversaries and all those things only last for a little while. People give you anniversaries. Someone give you anniversaries. Can't stand you next month. Listen, we got to give glory to God. This is what it's all about. You're getting too old and life is too short to play with this. Getting too old and life is too short to play with this, saints. We got to run this race. Run it. Run it. Run it with what? Patience. Run this race. Let patience be your pace. Run this race with patience that is set before you. Staying focused on God. Stand focused on the Lord. Stand focused on him. The Bible tells us in that Hebrews 12 and 3, consider him. Considering him. Because he withstood. He stood. Praise God. He stood against all the troubles, all the situations, all the things that men accused him of. He stood. Stood for who? Stood for my sake. Stood for my sake. Lord, help me to have the right heart. Help me to be transformed. Matthew 5 and 8 said, blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. It's saying their lives have been transformed by the grace of God and truth. Their lives have been transformed. Pure in heart, their lives have been transformed. In the pure heart, the process of sanctification is ever conforming them into the image of Christ. I'm going to say that again. Their lives have been transformed by the grace of God in truth, the pure in heart. In the pure heart, the process of sanctification is ever conforming them into the image of Christ. Hallelujah. Oh, man, I'm excited about this. I'm thanking the Lord, hallelujah, for being all things. So we got to do what the Bible tells in Romans 13 and 14, but put on Christ, put on Christ. Make no provision for the flesh. The process of salvation begins and continues in the heart. The process of salvation begins and continues in the heart. I praise him today. I praise him today for his goodness. I praise him today for his glory, saints. People of God, you are blessed. Blessed and highly favored. Hallelujah. Continue to say, Lord, help us to walk in you. Help us to hold up your blood-stained banner. I've got a mission. I've got a purpose. Hallelujah. I got a mission. I said what I said. We got to say I'm on assignment. I'm on assignment. Praise the Lord. When in Nehemiah say, I'm doing a great work for the Lord and I will not come down. I will not come down. They wanted to meet with him and oh no. He said, I'm not coming. Oh no. That's what you got to tell him. I ain't coming. Oh no. Oh no, you're not going to bring me down. We got to continue to stand. I'm closing on the scripture that I read earlier in Psalms 143 and 8. Cause me to hear thy loving kindness in the morning, for in thee do I trust. Cause me to know the way wherein I shall walk, for I lift up my soul unto thee. Deliver me, O Lord, from my enemies. I flee unto thee to hide. Teach me to do thy will, for thou art my God. Thy spirit is good. Lead me into the land of rightness. Merciful Father, we thank you today. Lord, we thank you for your many blessings. We thank you, Lord God, for your glory. Continue to touch our hearts and minds this morning. We pray unto you. We pray unto you, Lord God, for all things are before you. Let us walk in your power. Let us walk in your authority. Don't let us allow the enemy to cause us to minimize all that you are. All that you are, for you are great, and you are excellent and worthy to be praised. Bless and keep your people saved and strengthened right now. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray and ask it all. Amen, amen. God bless. God bless you, saints of God. God bless you, my friends. I love you. Keep praying for us. Keep praying for me, my family. Praise God in Jesus' name. Happy Father's Day, my brothers. Love you.